It's impossible.
How do I compare thee? How do I compare thee? How do I compare thee to a summer's day?
Quite frankly, Chance, I don't give a damn.
Do you have warts?
Oh, jeez. Mr. Miller, is it? We weren't expecting you for another 20 minutes. Not a problem at all. Welcome to Bowman Carson. My name's Steve Crow. Apologies for the protesting outside. I hope it wasn't too hard to get through them. If you don't mind, can you place your briefcase down on the conveyor belt there so I can check it for you? Okay, great. I just need to check through it. Sorry about this. Right, this all seems to be in order. Here's your ID badge. If you could just follow me to the security desk. Great. Doesn't that painting just freak you out? Yeah, it's kind of weird.
Ah, Mr. Miller. We didn't expect you so early. Let me just print your agenda. Give me a second. Your first is... speak of the devil. Carla. This is Mr. Miller from the Turing Post. You have a meeting today, I believe.
Yes, of course. A pleasure to meet you, Mr. Miller. Is it that time already?
No. Mr. Miller is just fashionably early.
Good. For a moment, I thought I was running behind. I'll be ready in my office for our meeting as scheduled. I have to run, I'm afraid, but we'll speak soon. Thank you, Dan.
Righty-o, Carla. Right, here's your agenda. Great. Why don't you read that over and put it in your briefcase for safekeeping? I suppose that's everything from me. If you need anything further, you know where I am.
What are you up to anyway? You got a busy day.
Yeah, you could say that. Oh, hey, Dan's been going on about some email about your password or something.
Oh, not this again.
What's going on?
Oh, it's stupid.
Really? I don't know what it's about. Just that it's a security risk or something?
Only if you're flipping psychic. Honestly, it's getting to be a joke.
Why? What's going on?
It's basically, my password is written on one of the items on my desk. Nobody would know that, though, if everyone would just stop talking about it.
Oh, I see. What's the password?
I'm not telling you, dummy.
Hey!
Anyway, what are you up to tonight? Are you coming to the pub with us?
Maybe. I can't really afford it till payday, so...
Oh, come on. I'll sort you out.
Sort me out? Like, beat me up?
No, like, buy you a pint. You're gonna need to pick up the lingo if you're gonna last around here, Stephen.
Yeah, right. Okay. I might see you there.
No worries.
Mr. Miller, don't forget your meeting with Carla. Just find something to do in the meantime.
I'm not ready for our meeting yet, Mr. Miller. Can you come back later?
I hope you're all right, Mr. Miller. Little guys will be so happy.
No floppy disks detected. No floppy disks detected.
Everything dated the 10th of the 4th, 1987, the day of the attack, has been boxed and archived and still needs reviewing. The phone records were particularly interesting to me. I've looked through about 20% of all the files I've collated as of yet, and I'm not sure exactly how much more I'm going to find. I'm certain I'm onto something big, but I fear it's going to take me a lot longer than I have to find what I need. Everything dated the 10th of the 4th, 1987, the day of the attack, has been boxed and archived and still needs reviewing. The phone records were particularly interesting to me. I've looked through about 20% of all the files I've collated as of yet, and I'm not sure exactly how much more I'm going to find. I'm certain I'm onto something big, but I fear it's going to take me a lot longer than I have to find what I need.
Chance. No, I've got too much going on. Sure. Well, the new ink arrived yesterday, but it was late, so I've had to start the new posters today. Oh, good. Yeah, I'm sure he will. can come over and take a look if you don't trust me. Maybe I can come over and check your codes at the same time. Yeah, all right then.
Come on, you need to get out of this area, now.
Steve, find Mr. Miller and tell him in no uncertain terms, we don't accept foul play in the Bowman Carson group.
Come with me.
Right, I've heard some alarming news. Steve tells me you've been found in a staff-only area. I cannot stress enough, Mr. Miller. The information housed in this facility is under the most strict protection. We can't have just anyone going through the public's private information now, can we? I'm willing to give you the benefit of the doubt this time. I appreciate you have a job to do. But so do I, Mr. Miller. So please, from now on, stick to the rules, okay? Your next appointment is with Miss Burman. I trust you know the way.
If you're in there, you gotta come out. Is someone in here? Is anyone in here? If I find anyone in here, there's gonna be trouble.
Floppy disks detected. No floppy disks detected.
Hey, Dan, I can't find it. I'm gonna go back to what I was doing.
No floppy disks detected. No floppy disks detected.
Thank you.
Steve, there's been an alarm set off. Can you go check it out?
Please insert token.
What a handsome fellow.
Harvey, I've been going through more of Alex's interview tapes. I found something quite alarming that seems to have been very quickly dismissed. He says his key card was stolen earlier on the day of the explosion. He said he tried to log it with Carla Burman. I'm not sure how frequently she leaves her office, but if you can somehow gain access, you may be able to find evidence linking her to Alex's key card.
Listen, Mr. Miller, I know this probably has nothing to do with you, but there was an alarm that went off earlier on, so if you could just make sure to stay in the allocated areas, that would be great.
What was that?
Please enter PIN. Code accepted. Access granted.
All right, I need to get my eyes tested. I give up.
tired for this nonsense. Something move over there. Oh, forget it. This can wait. My posters can't.
I'm going to need your clothes, your keys, and your motorcycle. Man, I'm good.
Marlon.
Hello, Carla.
Hello, Marlon.
Please enter PIN.
What the hell?
Code accepted. Access granted.
What was that?
Get it, I've got a meeting to get to soon anyway.
Please enter PIN. Code accepted. Access granted.
All right, Mr. Miller.
Please insert token.
Steve, I'm just getting a drink of water. Can you cover me?
Please insert token.
Thank you.
Harvey, I just received an anonymous fax. Do you know where the Turing meeting room is? It seems as though Alex Dubois may have hidden some information in there which proves the Bowman-Carson group are intentionally inflating figures based around the Union Act. If you're able to find the evidence, it may help inform the public about what the truth is here. I'm sure Carla Burman may have a thing or two to say about those figures, since she's the one spreading them in her print media. Anyway, let me know what you find.
Yes, I'm sure it will. Oh. Alex Dubois, you mean? Look, I'm not sure what he said.
What's up?
I can assure you, whatever it is, it's not true.
All right, stay in.
Thank you, sir. Of course. Thank you, Charles. Yes, I will. I'll keep you updated.